Okay, this is the project we're going to be doing today. It is a paper towel holder that I bought from Patricia Rawlinson's website, creativeartslifestyle.com. The paper towel front here is removable so that you can paint on both sides. And the topper comes off. It's magnetic so that you can replace it with another topper. This was a great project to do, so I'm looking forward to painting it with you. So let's get started. Okay, this project we're going to be painting a paper towel holder. And I bought this paper towel holder from Patricia Rawlinson's website at creativeartslifestyle.com. It comes with everything you see here and the hardware. Comes in pieces. This is the base. The dowel rod goes here. It has the screw that screws it into the bottom. The topper is magnetic. It has a magnet in there, and then this just has a screw and a washer on it. So if you find something else somewhere that you like, just put a screw and a washer in it and it will become magnetized to it. She sells other toppers because this is also her Lazy Susan also has toppers, and so for different patterns she'll have different toppers. And then the panel here is two-sided. She has made it so that you can attach it with screws here and paint something on each side so you can flip it over for different seasons or different patterns. So we're going to get this sealed. So before I seal this, I am going to take some press and seal wrap and put on one side of this, and then take it to a cutting mat and trim around it so that it fits as close to the piece as possible, so that when I paint this side, no paint seeps under to the other side. So I'm going to get this on, get it trimmed, and we'll come back and start getting it base coated. Okay, we're going to start sealing these, and I'm just using some all-purpose sealer. The brand that I have is Delta. But DecoArt has one as well. That's just the one that I have on hand here. So I'm just going to take a dampened sponge. This is just a moon-shaped sponge, but I like the way that I can grip it and kind of get into different areas. I did remove the screw out of the bottom of this. You see it was just screwed on there, the screw and the washer, so that I could paint without anything getting caught there. I have the back of mine sealed with some press and seal, and I trimmed it with just a X-Acto knife on a cutting mat. So we're ready to go. We're going to put one coat of sealer on all the pieces. I dampened my sponge, and then I got all of the excess water out of it. I think how you use your sponge is a personal preference, but I like to get mine damp because then when I go to clean it, the paint or whatever I've used with that sponge does not stick into the sponge as much. It comes out much easier if you have a damp sponge already. So I'm just going to seal all of these pieces. Now, I am going to seal the bottom of this, but I'll probably put a base coat on it, but I'm not sure, you know, how well I will do that, because I'm planning on putting cork on the bottom of mine. So I may not even paint the bottom. Well, I can't do that. Well, I can with the screw. After I screw it together, I can put cork on it. I was going to put adhesive cork on it. I should never need to take that dowel rod out of there. But if I do, the adhesive cork will come off. And then after we get all the sealer on this, we're going to lightly sand it when it's dry, and we'll come back and put a second coat on everything, second coat of sealer. But when I do that, I'm going to mix it in with my paint. So when I get ready for the second coat of sealer, I will mix it. I'm going to base coat this with espresso. Your dowel rod, your topper, and your base. You can base whatever color is going to be compatible for what you're painting. I'm just going to go ahead and base the whole thing with espresso because I know that will be a nice color for any other project that I paint. I don't know the detail that I'm going to put on this. When I get done painting this, it will determine how I want my topper to look. So for now, I'm just going to get everything sealed, dried, and then base coat it with equal amounts of sealer and paint. And it's going to be espresso. Alright, so I'm going to get this dry and get my base coat mixed up. Okay, I'm mixing my base coat. I'm doing sealer and espresso. I'm just going to take my palette knife and mix those together. This will give the piece an extra coat of sealer. That on this piece, it's not as big of an issue, but on pine can really, the grain can really raise a lot once it gets wet. So I want to make sure that it is sealed good. So I'm going to take the same sponge that I used earlier. I'm just going to wipe the palette knife on there. Now you probably won't see it too much on this piece yet. Because it's very close to the color of the background of the original surface. Gonna keep going and getting everything base coated here. I'm going to dry it and I'm going to put a second base coat on everything. And then we'll start in from there. I just wanted to mention as I'm base coating these that on your second coat you do not have to use a coat that has sealer in it. Just on the first coat just gives it a little bit of extra sealing for the piece. For the surface, especially on this pine. Okay, I'm gonna get those dry. Okay, I've got the two base coats on all of my pieces, and now I'm just gonna lightly sand to make sure there's no rough places. This is just a foam sander that I'm using here. Barely skimming over it. I just want to feel that it's smooth to the touch. Okay, I'm going to set the dowel rod and the base aside. We probably won't be doing anything else to them. Surface to start with. Okay, I want to get some more of my espresso out. These bottles are down the floor. Just a little bit. I want to thin it with some water. Soft black on my palette. We're going to do a little bit of antiquing on the edges with the sponge. Okay, sponge damp. So I'm just going to lightly coat my surface with this. You can also use a roller to paint this. You do not have to use a sponge. That's a personal preference. A lot of times I do use a roller. Okay, I'm going to tap that off on my paper towel because it's got a lot of water in it. Now I'm just going to go and pick up some soft black on my sponge. And I want to start on the edges in just a like swirling motion. And then I'm going to take the side that has no paint, but just water, and blend that out. I will have to do this probably 2 times to get the intensity that I want there along the bottom. And around the edges. So it's just a swirling little motion. Get that dry, and then we're going to put a second coat on it. Okay, on the topper, I want to just brush blend the soft black and the espresso. So I've just put them both on my brush on each corner, and then I'm just going in here and just dabbing here and there to create a little bit of texture on this topper. Get everything dry and get our pattern transferred on. Okay, we're ready to start base coating here. I've got my pattern on, and I am going to undercoat all these lemons with light buttermilk because yellow is such a transparent color. I'm going to thin my paint with a little bit of water. Get a smoother coat on there. Okay, so I'm going to base coat all of my lemons. I'm not going to base coat the leaves and all of my letters with light buttermilk. Okay, we're going to start base coating in these lemons. And I did a little test with some lemon yellow, and it's way too bright to start out with. So we're going to start out with moon yellow, and then we're going to brighten as we go. So we're going to get all of the outer parts of the lemons covered with moon yellow. Using a number 4 round for these smaller lemon places, rind. I didn't undercoat my letters with light buttermilk because I may paint them in with green, and I didn't want that undercoat under there. I may change my mind by the time I get to the letters, but that's my plan for now. Now, I've only painted lemons one other time, and that was a couple of years ago. I don't remember whose pattern it was. So when I decided I wanted to paint lemons and I drew out my pattern, I'm thinking, what color are the leaves for lemons? Are they a dark leaf or are they bright? And the leaves for lemons are quite a vibrant green. I just assumed they would be dark. So that will be quite a nice contrast to this yellow. Come back and do some stuff there. While that dries, I'm going to go ahead and base coat in my leaves with Hauser Medium Green. And this one has a folded place on it, but we're not going to worry about that right now. We'll put that in, put it back in a little bit later. So right now, I've got too much water in my brush, so I just laid it on the paper towel till all the water came out. Now I've painted over my graphite lines here, so I have to make sure that if I don't want those graphite lines to be seen, that I put an appropriate coating of paint on there to cover that. Otherwise, the graphite lines will be seen. If you can paint without painting over your graphite lines, that's good, because then you can just come back and erase them. Have to get all your base coating on. I'm going to go back and put a second coat of yellow on here. This is moon yellow, in case I didn't say that earlier. I've already got in my mind that I want to do some blueberries. Some raspberries, not blueberries. Just going to go crazy with the fruit, it seems like. I should not be using this small brush for this. It's making me work way too hard, causing me to leave bridges. I my bigger brush here. I like to put my coats on thin. I probably said that earlier when I was doing my base coating. And this base coating on this one is not as good as I would have liked. It left a few ridges, but I'm being able to smooth it out somewhat by this yellow that I'm putting on it. Put my second coat on my leaves. Okay, now the inside of the lemons, they have this white rind stuff. I'm going to mix some white and light buttermilk, which is going to be very close to the color that I based it in. But I want to create that almost scalloped look the lemons have. So I'm thinning my paint a little bit. There they are. I like this on the inside. Looking a little silly at the moment, but as we start adding more and more to this, this is just to get that white part that is on the edge of like lemons and oranges and things after you peel them. Sure what that's called. Now this one will be a little bit different. Just blending that out in there. It's Kickoo. So I can have it smooth there. I have to add some yellow underneath that. They're still pretty wet. Okay, I want to add some lemon yellow to my moon. See how that looks. I might have to go with cad yellow. Yeah, I'll get cad yellow instead of lemon yellow. Now, a lot of the lemons that you get at the restaurants seem to be more towards the white inside. Limes are green, and technically lemons should be more on the yellow side on the inside. So I'm going to create those. Oops. A little bit too far. I don't want to go all the way to the edge of my white. So I'm mixing cad yellow and moon yellow. I'm going to start about here. Come into the middle. To make ridges as you do it. Okay, we'll come back and lighten that up. Do the same to all of these that are cut. No, it's not looking like much right now. But it will. It's in its ugly duckling stage right now. I'm gonna let those slices dry for a little bit. Start some shading on the big lemons, the whole lemons. I am going to use antique gold to start with. And let's see. I want a bigger float, so I'm going to use a 12 curved flat brush. Oh, Cornell, they make a 6, 10, and a 12. I like them because they make your floats very soft. And they're just a great brush for floating. Now, the one thing that you do need to have on your palette when you are floating is water drops. So I take just a spray Mr. Bottle that I bought in the travel section at Walmart, and I spray water on here. And I want big and small drops depending on what size brush I'm going to use. And that's the water that you use when you're floating instead of going to your water basin. So I'll pick the water up on the heel side of the brush. The paint will go on the pointed or the toe side. And you want to create a soft float, and to do that, I've got a little bit too much water in my brush right now, so I'm just laying it on my paper towel and letting the excess water work out, and then I'm coming back over here. And how soft this is right here is how soft it will be when I go to paint. And when you're floating, you want to use soft pressure and lay the brush flat. Now, I'm going to draw this in. I don't think that you can see where these two lemons are. There we go. Pencil didn't want to come out. So I'm going to draw that line there. My eraser and erase that back just a little bit. I don't want it to be too dark. I just want to know where it's at. Okay. So I'm going to start on this side here. I'm laying my brush flat. I don't try to get it all in one swoop. And I'm just kind of walking it out. And I'll take my mop brush and soften that. I start on the water side, and then I go into the paint just very softly. Take it to a damp place on your paper towel, wipe it off, a dry spot, dry it off, you're good to go. They make mop brushes in white bristles and black. I like the white because I can see when it's dirty. Okay, let's float a little bit on this one. Tapping that, softening it out. Okay, and up here on this part, I want to create that it. I'm going to go ahead and put a little bit on these as well. Now you can go to a smaller brush to try and stay off of the background, because that is a two-tone background. If it was a solid color, I wouldn't worry about it as much. I'm just making a huge mess here. I probably will come back at the end and deepen up the soft black around the edges. I can already tell it's not dark enough for me. get your best floats, you need to have a combination of three things: the right amount of paint, the right amount of water, and the right amount of pressure. Most people don't have enough water and too much paint, or they have too much water, not enough paint. And then when they go to paint, they're just pushing down as hard as they can. And they need to keep their pressure light and lay the brush flat. So it's flat, not up on the side or anything like that, unless you're doing a really tight float where you need to just be on the toe. That's dry, so I'm going to bring that out a little bit. I'm going to walk that out. Mop it very gently. Almost every time I go to get paint, I'm picking up water droplets first, and then I'm going to get the paint. Something in my brush here. Okay, I think on the centers of these, I want the very center will have a light spot in it. But from that light spot will come this almost star thing. So I've just got it on the toe of this brush, and I'm just patting it in a circle, leaving that center because that's where I'm going to put the white in there. This is the same way that you do a bullseye float, only you close that circle. And then you take your mop brush and soften it all. It is a beautiful day here today for January. It is in the 60s, but by Monday, we're only going to be, today is Saturday, by Monday we're only going to be in the 20s with a wind chill in the single digits. So I am not looking forward to that. Winter, not my favorite season. Okay. I'm going to create a little ridge around the where the rind and the number 6 curb flat. Try and darken that up a little bit there. I'll see if you get the right paintbrush. Got all this water on my ferrule, and I don't want that to go down and get on my project, so I'm just wiping it off. Okay, I think with this one here, I'm going to make pretty much all of this dark. I'm staying up on the toe of this small curved flat. The one thing about using smaller brushes is that you have to go back for paint more often, because it doesn't hold as much paint, so it doesn't carry it as far. I still try to go pick up some small water drops whenever I come back for paint. Make sure I've got you on camera. Oops. Painting with the wrong side of my brush. Highlight on here. I'm going to use the lemon yellow and see how that works out. And then we'll let the lemons get good and dry and we'll go work on the leaves and come back to the lemons. Okay, that's not too often noticeable. So I will start with that. That's a good color to start building on. I'm just walking it out. I used to be intimidated by painting fruit. And it's just like everything else. If you just break it down into layers and sections, it becomes so much easier. When you tend to look at the whole object in the whole, you know, as the complete item, then that's when, you know, it can be mind-boggling for some. So I break it down the same way that I break down my lettering, you know, just in strokes and highlights and shades. And okay, let's go work on the leaves while those settle down a little bit. And I'm going to use my 10 curved flat. Find one that's not too awful worn out. I use these brushes a lot, so they are starting to get worn. Before I paint them, though, I'm going to see if I can erase some of this graphite. If I didn't paint over it, it will come off. And I'm going to draw the place that's going to be the curved part of this one leaf. I'm just using a dressmaker's pencil because it comes off with water or paint. Okay, we are going to shade with some black green. It's a new bottle, so I'm really shaking it up. I'm going to use my bottle opener. Open it up. Usually that will tear it so I can pull it right off, but if not, I always keep just some small scissors right here at my table so I can tear that off. Excuse me. I want to create this dark area in the bent part of this leaf. I'm going to lay my brush flat. I've got the right amount of paint and the right amount of water, so it's creating that softness in there. I'm going to gently tap it. And that just increases the softness that you've already put in there. Blends it out nicely. Okay, so this leaf up here, I want the centers of the leaves to be the darkest and the outer part of the leaves to be the lightest. So I'm going to do a back-to-back float down the centers of these. And you could certainly do this with a much smaller brush than I'm using here. And then we will put a vein down the center. And mop brushes also come, you know, smaller sizes if you don't want to try and mess with a big one. This one's a quarter inch. This one is a half inch. Okay. Okay, we're going to go down the center of this one. Get you on camera here. Both sides, back to back. We mop it. Okay, now this folded one, I want to do the same thing with it. Create that dark stuff in the center there. I'm won't be too much mopping on that one. Okay, now I want this folded part right here, I want to darken that. It gives it the illusion that it is turned. Lemon leaves are much darker in the center than they are anywhere else, but they are really bright leaves. So for the highlight, I'm going to use avocado dip. It's pretty bright, and I think I'm going to use my 6 curved flat to do this. A little bit of water. Okay, I'm going to start on this one here. I know you're probably looking at that thinking, whoa, that's bright. But when it dries, it will soften down. But we want that brightness on these leaves. Okay, this one here. On camera. And then I want to do this turned part. Now this leaf, you can choose to have it laying, have it under this one or on top of it. I painted it to where it's on top. I think I originally drew it where it was on the bottom. So that's going to be a personal preference. I come back and intensify this just a little bit when we're done as well. Okay. I'm not going to worry about the veins in the center until I get the stems on the lemons. Okay, I want to use a 10-0 liner, and I'm going to take my light buttermilk, and I'm going to create that center place in the lemons, and then start creating some of that whiteness that divides those sections. So I'm just going to tap it in the center. do. Make sure your paint is thinned with water to the consistency of ink. I'm just going to start pulling these down into there. Stay up on the tip of the brush, and that's how you can create those finer lines. Okay. Do that to all of these lemons. Paint was coming off my brush too thick, so I had to go add some water to it. I want those fine, fine lines. Got off my pattern there. Okay. Starting to look a little bit more like lemons, aren't they? Take my round brush, and I need to create some yellow on this side of this lemon. That's something to set on. It's kind of turned a little bit not right for where that way the back is. So I'm going to create a little bit of rind here. Peeling, I guess I should say. I'll have to go back and fix the rind part. Okay, that looks much better. Go in with my, I think I'm going to use my 6 curved flat, and I want to go in with some light buttermilk and white mix on my brush. So that means I pick up both on my brush and then I just blend them together. I want to redefine this white area. I painted over that graphite line, so I have to make sure that I can cover it with something. So I want to go where each one of these divisions are and really intensify that. good if I keep you on camera, huh? Well, that wasn't the one I was working on. Okay, now I want to fill that in where the yellow and the white come together. I know you're thinking, oh, she just made those little flowery things on there. Well, I don't really want the flowery things to... I want them, but up there, not down here. I'll come back with my yellow and create a really sharp, sharp edge there. In the water, my paint is not wanting to flow very well. Okay, I need to go back down here and put some yellow. Just go ahead and add the antique gold to it because that's what color it needs to be. This one over here. My paint wasn't flowing, so I went over and picked up a couple of water drops and added it to it. Okay, that looks so much better. Highlight on that rind there. Okay. I'm going to leave those for a minute. Let them get good and dry. I'm going to go back and do a second highlight. I'm going to use that lemon yellow again. If I think it's not giving me the brightness that I want, I will add some light buttermilk to it. Lemons don't tend to be smooth skinned, so we'll have to figure out that texturing look that's on them. deepen in the center of these. And I'm going to use the tin curved flat because I can get a wider float. So I'm going to go back with the antique gold. I want to create almost a wash. And I want to do the centers first. And then we're going to add some more of this on here. More water. My paint wasn't moving at all, so it was way too dry. Okay. Now I want to use that same color, but I am going to go to the smaller, the 6-inch, not the 6-inch, this number 6 curved flat. I'm going to put some fresh antique gold out. And I want to put some of this color back here on these ends. Picking up teeny tiny water drops, a little bit of paint each time that I go back to my palette. feel like I'm being way too quiet on this DVD. Like, I'm concentrating way too hard. Probably keeping you completely off camera. Bright yellow. Okay, how's that looking? I think let me try something and see how it looks. I may not like it. I need to repaint those white lines in there. So I'm thinning out some light buttermilk and white mixture. And I'm going to go back and intensify these. I keep turning it, then I keep forgetting to look over my shoulder at the camera. Make sure you're in the frame. So I do apologize for that. Deepen around the shading around the edges of these. I might need to use a smaller brush. Got that on my brush. I think I'm going to deepen the shading down here. 6 to do that. I'm going to place right up here on this lemon where the stem goes in. See that. I'll have to come back and I don't want any water on my brush. Give it a little highlight on this other edge. You'll probably see that better. Now we're going to go do our stems. And then we'll come back to these lemon slices again. Okay, our stems are going to be espresso and antique gold mixed. I'm just going to brush mix them. You can use a 10-0 liner or a small round brush. I think I'm going to use a 1 round. If I can find it. I have a specific one that I like to use. So I'm going to brush mix these two paints, espresso and antique gold. And I'm going to create my stem. I drew it coming off this way. I'm going to take that same color and put it on the ends of these. We're going to come back with avocado dip and add our veins. Okay, so we just want to stay up on the very tip of this brush. Create that center vein. Should be thinned with water to the consistency of ink. I could tell I had too much paint on the tip of my brush, so I went and touched it to the paper towel and took off the excess. Okay, now we want to just create some little veins in here. Something you're going to see a whole lot of when the piece is completely dry. Add a little bit of lemon yellow to that avocado dip. I'll just lighten it up just a little bit. I want to go back over that center vein. Okay, and I want to take that color because it is the color that's in our lemons, that lemon yellow color. Use it a little bit on the leaves. This is just straight lemon yellow. You don't have to use it on all the leaves. Fresh paint out. Okay. Now I want to take some of that green and put it onto my lemons. So I want the Hauser light or Hauser medium green. I'm going to use that one. And I'm just going to wash it in a couple of places. So that means I'm thinning the paint down fairly thin with water. At least 90% water and 10% paint. And then I went and dried my brush off on my paper towel, and then I have a little bit of that wash on here. So wherever you think your lemon isn't quite ripe or still has that little bit of green tint to it, that's where you want to put that. And after we get the speckling on here, we will probably come back and intensify that a little bit more. So on this one, I think I want it to be down here on this side. Mop it and soften that. Gently. You see me every now and then rubbing it in my hand. That's just to dry it off if I feel like I've gotten too much water. Because then it will just take off the paint that I just put on there, and I don't want that to happen. Okay, let's put a little bit on a couple of these. Some down here on this one. Just back here. Okay, where the stem is, let's put a second coat on those stems. Espresso and antique gold mixed. They're pretty substantial little stems because they grow on a tree and a branch, so don't think they have to be tiny, tiny. Okay, I'm going to take a little bit of moon yellow. Put a little bit of that in there. Just add a little bit of moon yellow onto this stem. And then this one down here as well. And I think I'm going to add a touch of soft black. Just a tiny, tiny little bit. And put that down in here a little bit on this side. I don't want to do too much because I've got that color in my background. So I want to carry it into there. I just don't want it to take over. Okay, now I want to deepen where these stems go into it. So I'm going to take some espresso. And just put that down in there. To do the little stippling stuff with these lemons, and then we'll finish out these slices. Let's see. I don't know how well this is going to work, but I've got these curved foliage brushes, I think they're called. They're royal. They're very stiff. They're perfect for doing foliage. I'm going to try and tap some. Use them wet. You get it full of water. And then you go to your paint. Fill it with paint. And then mush it all around. You mush it, mush it, mush it. Mush that those bristles out. I'm getting lemon yellow and cat yellow, and I think I'm going to put them both in my brush at the same time. So when I say mush it out, I mean mush it out like this. You're really mushing that brush out. Just squish it. Okay, we're going to be tapping up on the very, very tip of these bristles. And see if we can create some of those, some of that rough texture that's on lemons. I'll probably have to come back with some buttermilk, light buttermilk, and yellow. Starting to see it on there. To be extra careful over here. I don't want to get it everywhere. With just straight lemon yellow. Repeat that. I have no idea if this is the right or wrong way to do lemons. It's just the way that I chose to do them. I want to take a little bit of antique gold, mix that in there, because I want to create some a little bit of darker places where these, a little bit more. I don't know how that's relaying on camera. It's not doing too bad. Okay, I need to go back with the lemon yellow. I think I'm going to have to get some buttermilk on here. I'm just mixing that buttermilk on my brush and create some little lighter places where the highlight is. The highlight side is. bit of that green on here. Intensify my highlight. I can tell right here to separate these two. So I'm going to go in with some light buttermilk and some lemon yellow mix. I want these two to really be separated. So I might have to go and increase that. Increase that shading there on that. Almost too light there. I'm going to have to wash over these with some lemon yellow, I think. Just need to separate those a little bit more. That shading to be just a little bit darker, so I'm going to take antique gold and a little tiny bit of espresso. Some seeds in here. Now, lemon seeds are pretty white, but I'm going to add a little bit of lemon yellow to my buttermilk. Add some seeds. Wherever you think seeds need to be in here. Generally, whenever I get a lemon at a restaurant, it is full of seeds. So, probably have to go over these twice. You just pick and choose where you want your lemon seeds to be. I'm just using a number one round brush. I'm just touching down. Light buttermilk and lemon yellow mixed together. Now you can do this exact same technique for limes. Just change it to some green colors. I think I want a couple of seeds. My original drawing, let me bring it out here. I drew some seeds laying here and there, and some lemon juice kind of running out. So I think I'm going to do that I'm going to turn it this way because I want to pull towards me for my seed. Make some juice. We may just put some seeds in the juice, the lemon juice too. Make some lemon juice out here. Okay, I'm going to use, let's see, no, caviolo. I'm using my curved flat, and I've only loaded it on one side. So we want the juice to be running off of the lemon. Puddle of juice right there, which I know they don't look like much right now, but we're going to intensify that. So I'm going to go with cad yellow. Create that intensity in there. You want it to be pretty transparent. It is, after all, just lemon juice, and it's not very dark to begin with. Okay, I think I'm gonna, before I go any farther, wash over these with cad yellow or lemon yellow. I'm not sure which one I want to use. I think I'm going to use cad yellow. So I'm thinning it down. 90% water, 10% paint. I feel like that completely covered up our highlight. So I'm going to touch right there and try and remove that off of the highlight. Just want them more lemony looking. I should really get a smaller brush for this. Thank you. glaze over my centers of mine. As well with cad yellow and a little bit of antique gold. Because the centers of the lemons are just a little darker. Now I'm going to have to... I think I'll just leave those. I'm going to go back and intensify my seeds, I think. Let's see, I used white buttermilk and lemon yellow. Go. Stick with that. More light buttermilk. I got it too dark. I want my seeds to stand out a little bit more. Seed in there, maybe a little seed here, a couple seeds in here. Okay, I want to put a little bit more green on these lemons, just a little bit more. So I'm going to make another little wash. Just have it on my toe, the toe of this brush. I want to shade behind this one here because it's on top of that one. So a little bit of antique gold. My dogs just came in here and they are making horrible noises over here on the floor. I just want you to know that's not me. That is my dogs. Touch of a highlight on this one. Just brighten that up there. So it stands out a little bit more on top of that one. Just a tiny bit of a highlight on this one as well. And down here, a little bit darker. Just a tad bit lighter. juice area. I really need that to be darker. So I think I'm going to take a little bit of antique gold and cadmium and mix it together. But I just want the very outer edge of that to be darker. That's much better. Because as it pools, it's darker. And where it's closest to the lemon is where it's going to be the lightest. Try and create a little bit of cast shadow down here. And I'm going to do that with soft black. I'm starting out with my tin curved flat. I may have to go to a bigger brush. So I'm just going to start. I need to go over that, but I don't want it to be so wide that it covers it all up. Blend it out a little bit. I may have to go with black. Soft black may not show up. So let me get a little bit of black here. I could use espresso on the So I'm going to mix some of that black in with my soft black just to make that soft black a little bit darker. To go up on that. I think I'm going to use a flat brush here. This one's probably going to be too big. I don't know how well that's translating on the camera. Deepen this in here. How this is going. Tessa? I had to instruct my dogs to get out. They just came in here and decided to make all kinds of ridiculous noises. They love being in here with me when I paint. And I love having them in here. But The other day my dog was snoring, and every time I went to do a float or to put my brush down and paint, she would snore right when I was doing it, and every single time I would jerk. So it's just better for my painting if they're in here and they're quiet. Darker right there. I'm going to use espresso. Create some darker shading here. I should stop and get fresh paint, but as you can see, I'm not. Do the same over here, because this just needs to be, to me, darker. I'm gonna have to do my highlight because I just painted over it. How much soft black got into the background here. But I do need to touch this up right here. To kind of meet. I ended up putting that black mixture there, but I'll put a little bit of brown on it. Where this leaf lays on top of this one, I need to put just a little bit of shading around that. So that you can tell it's on top. That's just with the espresso that I was doing that. Now I'm just looking at it and trying to see what areas need some intensifying. Now I'm just using straight espresso and creating some of the darker areas. Okay, the last thing I want to do down here on these lemons is create on the white. I want to just wash some yellow on that. Not all the way across it. I just want to do it next to the rind. If you bought my apples DVD, I did this with the apples. And it really made it look like a... complete slice. So I'm just putting a little bit of cad yellow, trying to keep that very thin, soft float. Too much water. I still want all that white part to stay white, but I need it to become part of the lemon instead of standing out on its own. Some more espresso along the very top edge. I like the way this one looks. So I want this one to look similar. Okay, I'm going to leave the lemons alone for a while and just let them be, and I'll come back and look at them and see if there's anything else that I need to adjust after I paint the lettering. So the lettering, I think I am going to paint it in with Hauser medium green. I'm going to use four. You know, I think I'm going to use my one, maybe two. That's a six. My one round. I'm going to try it. If it's not big enough, then I will go to my four. Okay, I'm going to thin my paint down with water. Inky consistency. My can see it. Okay, now with lettering, if you pull down and towards you, that makes lettering so much easier. Never go across or up. Well, I guess I should say don't ever go up. You will come across somewhat, but don't ever go up because you don't have as much control over your brush. So you want to start here, and I'm pulling down. And then here, I'm pulling down. So I always want to be pulling down, and I always break up a letter in strokes. I try not to look at it as the whole letter, like that's the letter L. I just picture it in my mind as small strokes. So for instance, the E here, zoom you in just a little bit. I'm going to start at the top here, pulling down, 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 okay, this way down. I will go back when I'm done and erase any graphite lines that I did not cover up. So I tried to always make that movement a down towards me movement. And if you're using a good round brush, you can flatten it out and fill in that whole area. Way too much paint there. And when you get to more narrow areas on a letter, you just come up on the tip. So see, that's really narrow right there, so I'm just on the very tip of the brush. And then as it gets fatter, I'm going to flatten my brush out more and give it more pressure. Lettering is quite fun. And it's really not very difficult once you think about it as strokes. And it's all in the way that you're pulling and the pressure that you're giving the brush. So we'll get two coats on here. And then we'll see what we want to do from there. If we want to do some shading and highlighting on here, or drop shadow. Probably we'll do a drop shadow on here. I like doing that on lettering. I just think it really makes it pop. I really like this little round brush here because it will flatten out to like the size of a 2-flat. It's awesome, awesome, awesome brush. Just want to make sure I get this S right. It looked a little like I didn't have the lines right there. Anyway, this brush is a Winsor & Newton. Number one. It's a round brush. good set of round brushes. Very good to have. Okay, I'm going to let this dry and get the second coat on it. Okay, before we go up and finish the lettering, I want to add a little bit more shine on these lemons. So I'm going to go into light buttermilk first. And I'm just going to use an angle brush or my curved flat. I want to create a very definite highlight. So I want it to be round in that area, so I'm going to soften that. And then over here on this one, I'm going to give it some shine right here. Just kind of tapping that on there and using the water brush, the water side of the brush, to soften it, smooth it out. Okay, right here needs a little bit. Okay, on this one down here, I want to put a little bit more shine on it as well, so I'm going to create a very bold highlight right here. And I'm using the water edge of my brush, and I'm just kind of softening that out. And then this one here as well, a little bit brighter on this edge here. Okay, now I want to intensify that highlight. So I am going to take some more buttermilk. First, I want to make a little bullseye highlight on here. And I'm doing this the same way that I did the centers down there, only I'm letting the paint touch all the way around where the toe is. So I'm just dabbing it down, going in a circle. So I want to put one up here on this lemon. Right now I'm just using light buttermilk. I'm going to come back and intensify this with some white. Just take my mop brush and I just barely, I'm touching down on that, just blending that a little bit and smoothing it out. Just softening it. Okay, this one's going to have a shine right there. And then this one will just have a little bitty spot right here. I want to intensify that. I think I'm going to put a little bit of that light buttermilk down here. Kind of a reflective highlight down here. Okay, those are just reflective highlights. Okay, now let's go to some straight snow white, and we'll just intensify the highlight just a little bit. So this will be a much smaller area than I just did, so I'm just going to take it along this edge just a little bit. Tiny bit there, not much. Just a tiny bit there. Okay, now we're going to work on those bullseye areas, and I want this to be even smaller, so I'm up on the toe a little bit. So I'm just going to tap to soften that. on the toe, just creating this bullseye area just a little bit smaller. Just gently tap it. Then I clean it off on a wet spot and dry it off on a dry spot. And then here, some more paint. Just tapping that on there. And just a tiny bit over here. Okay, and since I have brightened up those lemons, I want to put one more highlight on the leaves. And let's see, I'm going to use some lemon yellow and light buttermilk mix. I'm just going to mix it on my brush. Pick up those two colors on the toe of my brush and then just go over there and blend them in. Okay, let's see. So, a little bit too much paint on my brush there. I'm just going to wipe some of it off. A little bit more of the lemon yellow, I think. I want them to be so much on the white, that highlight to be so much on the white side. I want it to be more on the yellow. And when I touch my finger to it, that's just softening it back. And that's all it's doing. Brush there. Okay, I think that's looking pretty good there. Alright, I need to fix my stem on this one. You can't see it very well anymore, so I'm going to take my espresso and a little bit of soft black. And mix them together. I want to make that stem be a little bit darker. Add a little bit of antique gold streak on there. Make that out too much. A bit more antique gold. I think I'm going to add a tiny bit of black under here on this side. That will define that a little bit more. I'll put some up here in this one since I put it in that one. Alright, I need to touch up in my espresso areas down here a little bit. And I kind of got out, so I'm just going to pick up a little bit of that on my brush and see if I can't cover that up a little bit where I got out of lines. Actually, it's where I touch my finger down to soften it, and then I touched right on the background. Okay, I think those lemons are looking pretty good, so let's go up here and finish on our lettering. I've got my two coats of Hauser medium green on there. So now I want to create a highlight and a shading on the bottom. Use my 6 curved flat. Get some more water drops on my palette here. Okay, I want to highlight the tops of these. I'm going to try cad yellow first and see if that gives me the look I'm wanting to go for. Okay. How I'm going to do this, in here a little bit. As I've just got it on the toe of this brush, and I just want to start it at the very top, and then I'm just going to slowly walk it down that letter. I'm going to have my handy Q-tip, because I know I'll be getting out of line. So I want to continue that about halfway down this letter. I've got too much water on my brush. I'm gonna get some more paint. Try this E. You could also do this by just using a round brush and dragging it. If you have a solid color background, you don't have to worry as much about if you get out of lines, because you can just go back with the color and touch it up. So that is, I think I'm going to go to a round brush and try these highlights on here with a round brush. So I'm going to go with the same color, the cad yellow. I'm loading up my round brush and I'm getting it to a flat. I flattened it out so that it's not round anymore. Okay, and I'm going to have to have just a little bit of water in that. I'm just going to drag it down the letter. Definitely need to have more water. I think that's going to be a little bit easier to do if I thin my paint down a little bit here. Stuck my hand in the black paint, so let me clean that off myself so I don't get it all over my project. Okay, let's try this. I've got cad yellow. I think that's going to work out a lot better. All right, let me get you on camera here. Go for this O. Farther down than I wanted on that end. I think on the bottoms we'll do pine green, or black green, I guess is what I shaded my leaves with. We'll do black green. I think I'm going to have to go back down to my leaves and add some yellow onto them. Let's do a quick second coat here. And then I'll go down to my leaves. And I want to do a drop shadow on these lettering as well. And I haven't decided yet what color I want to do that with. I'm also going to go back around the outside edge and shade a little bit of black, I think. Go put a little bit of cad yellow and Hauser medium green. I'll mix those together. Not too much Hauser medium green, I guess. I want to stay more towards the yellow, bright yellow side. I don't like on the leaves how this is too white now, because leaves on lemons are very bright. So I've just mixed cad yellow with a tiny, tiny bit of Hauser medium green. And I like that better. Finish this lettering up. Let me get some black green out. I'm just going to do it the same way that I did the top, only coming up from the bottom. And you don't have to fill the whole letter. You can leave some of that Hauser medium green showing through. Okay, I've turned it upside down because it's much easier to pull towards me. You want to pull that up into the yellow. I could probably go to a bigger round brush, but I didn't want it to completely fill that Hauser medium green up. Still wanted to have some of that showing through. Go back and do that a second time, and it's just going to be a quick little want to do my drop shadowing on the letters now. And I'm going to do it on the left side. I think I'm going to use light buttermilk. So I want to thin that down. Inky consistency. Wipe my brush off. I want to make sure I have no water on the ferrule. I'm going to load my brush up. And then we're going to do our lettering to the left side. Or our drop shadow, I guess I should say, to the left side. You could also do this on the right side. You could not do it at all. Is where it's a little bit easier for me to paint it. You see, as I'm coming down that letter, I'm putting pressure to make a bigger shadow area. Flattening the brush, standing up, coming up to a nice tip there. Okay, so there is your drop shadow on your lettering. I want the edges to be a little bit darker than what they are. So I'm going to take some soft black and black mixed together, which will make my soft black just that little bit darker, but not quite to the black stage. And I'm going to use a wide angle brush. It's a 3/4 inch angle brush. And I'm just going to start down here at the bottom. Going over that, I can see where I need to touch that up there. have a lot of water in my brush. I tend to use more water when I use a bigger brush. Okay, I'm going to let that dry for a minute and see how it looks. While it's drying, I want to take my screws that are going to be attached down here at the bottom. I don't want them to be this shiny silver. So I'm going to paint them. So I'm going to put a couple of coats of paint adhesion medium on them first. And then I'm going to paint them over with soft black to make them blend into the board so they're not seen. You can clean these with alcohol if you need to. So I'm just going to put a quick. I don't want my hole to fill up down there, so I'm going to dig that out of there. This will dry fairly quickly. This one's already dry, so let me get a second coat on it. And you don't have to paint your screws up if you don't want to. It's definitely one of those things that is your personal preference and choice. Okay, and I'm not going to worry about rinsing the paint adhesion medium out of my brush because get the right way here for you. It will just help, even if it's still in my brush, it will just help the paint stick to it. You can mix this paint adhesion medium with paint. Okay, I do want it to be colored down in there. I just don't want it to fill it down in the center of that screw. Okay. Lay it where it's off the edge of the table so it doesn't remove any of that wet paint. Okay, let's see how the board looks. Yeah, I like that little bit of black around the edges there. I think that really sets off. Now, when you seal this, you want to put two coats of sealer on it. I like to use a polycrylic sealer. It's water-based. It's just something you can buy at any hardware store. You gently stir it with a stick or a dowel rod. I use a dowel rod. I apply it with a damp sponge, two coats. I just sponge it on, let it dry. Normally, on the second coat, I go across, and if I still don't feel like it's, you know, like the finished coat looks as professional as I would like it to look, I will do a third coat back in the up and down direction. So let me check these screws. I think we're going to try and get this together real quick so you can see this finished project. Okay, my base, I did go ahead and put a little bit of soft black around the edge of it. You really won't see it, so it's not completely necessary to do that. Okay, and this one goes here. Oops. Everything's sticking to me now, magnetized. All right, let me get my screwdriver and get these screws screwed in, and then we will finish putting it together. Okay, I'm going to change my lettering because after I got this completely done, I wasn't very happy with how these letters looked. So I'm going to paint back over them with moon yellow. So lettering is done in a downward motion. Pull towards you and down. Need a little bit more water in my brush. I'm using a one round. So I'm just going to fill all of these letters back in with two coats of yellow, and then we'll see where we want to go from there. I may do my drop shadow with black instead of that light color, but I want to get these painted over with the yellow. I just think the letters should be yellow to match the lemons. And it's not a big deal to repaint over your lettering. You still know where it's at. It's still all done in the same manner. Downward strokes up on the tip, up here, and I'm flattening the brush out. Paint should be the consistency of ink. Tip, flattening out. Got a little bobble there, no big deal. So this is moon yellow. This is the color that we based in the lemons with. I think it will cover this color that I originally painted them. I think it will cover it very nicely. Lettering is really all about having the right size brush for the size letters that you're doing and the pressure that you give it as you go down that letter. more water in my paint. It's getting too thick. So I just went and picked up a little bit more water and added it to my paint. I have a ridge there. I don't want that. Ridges, I think, make your project look unprofessional. Okay. We've got our first coat of yellow on there. Moon yellow. So I'm going to dry this and get a second coat on it, and then we'll come back and do our drop shadowing. Okay, I've got my two coats of yellow on here. My moon yellow. But I want them to be as bright as what our lemons are. So, I am going to glaze over them with cad yellow. And the reason that I didn't paint them in with cad yellow to begin with is because cad yellow is very, very transparent. And it would not have covered the paint that was underneath it. So we are going to brighten these up. And I've switched to a bigger brush to glaze over these. And I'm just doing a glaze. Okay, yes, I'm liking that so much better. Now I want to do the drop shadow. And I think I'm going to use black to do the drop shadow. I think that will make those letters pop a lot more. So I need to thin my paint to inky consistency. That makes it flow off of your brush a lot better. Camera here. We're going to go to the left sides of these letters. Oh my lord, my dog is snoring. I'm sure you have to be able to hear that. Ridiculous. More pressure as I come down. I'm keeping you on camera here, this lettering detail. I want to make sure I cover up all of that original drop shadowing. that I did with that light buttermilk. Now see, even I don't know how a piece is going to turn out when I sit down to paint it. I've got an idea, but that idea doesn't always translate well. Sometimes you just gotta go back and rethink it and redo it. Okay, let me wide angle out. We can look at this. See what we think here. I think I might have to put a highlight on the top of the letters. So I'm going to do that with light buttermilk. So let me get you back in here so we can see how we're going to do this. I'm just using that same brush, and I just want to drag some of that down the tops to put a little bit more water in my brush. I probably will have to do this twice. I don't think once is going to show up too good. But I'm definitely liking the yellow on the letters much better. Go back and do it again. I have to get a little bit of water in my paint here. I think I want to put cad yellow on the bottom again. I'm just going to wash over that bottom again with some more cad yellow. I'm going to turn it this way because it will be easier for me. It's just a wash of yellow, which means it's going to be 80 to 90% water, and the rest is paint. Bring that white down just a little bit too far on that end, so I was able to fix it right there with that. OK. going to finish that. I think that's going to be just right. I like the yellow letters much better. Okay. Thank you so much. I hope that you enjoyed this project.